Hi! Today I'm going to be talking about being a social media artist while doing the finishing touches on this painting right here, which I've titled Hummingbird at the Theater. So there are people who will say that because you're seeing me painting this on your screen and you're hearing me talking to you and you have a connection to me through this thing we call the internet, that because of all this, I'm not a real artist. So I guess I should just hide in my little cave and just paint and draw in solitude so no one knows who I am or what I'm doing, and that'll make me a real artist. I'm just going to put it bluntly, anyone who tells someone that they're not a real whatever because they're on social media is behind the times. That's how you get your stuff out there. Like I said, I think these people are behind the times, or they could just be really jealous people who they don't have the courage to put their work out there, or they're even making work at all, and they want to insult those of us who do have that courage. But really, this you're not a real artist isn't anything new. 100 years ago, or 150 years ago, somewhere around that time, in Paris, there was something called an academy. And the academy dictated how you were supposed to paint as an artist. And if you didn't paint the way the academy wanted you to, you weren't a real artist, according to them. And there were people at the time who didn't paint the way the academy wanted them to, and they started a new movement, which was new at the time, to be called Impressionism. And of course now, Impressionism is a respected art style, and I believe there will come a time when being a quote-unquote social media artist, I think there'll come a time when there won't even be such thing as a social media artist, but just be artists who use social media, which is what I prefer to think of myself as. There are people that think that for some reason, if you have any success at all, or if you do anything that could give you any success as a creative person, somehow you're not real anymore. You need to be poor and starving. But honestly, I refuse to let anyone who's that ridiculous in their thinking make me feel bad. Either way, these people are going to have to get used to it because, well, websites will come and go. I think social media is here to stay. I made another video, I'll put a card up linking to it. In that video I talk about how I think social media can be good for artists, or I think it's called something like advantages of social media for artists or something, in which I say that basically you know that people on Facebook are expecting to see a photo of some progress of a piece of art you've made, you're probably more likely to actually paint even if you don't feel like it, because you don't want to disappoint people and you don't want to embarrass yourself by not having anything to post. I was actually inspired to make this video when I watched Mikey from Glam&Gore's video about how she became a makeup artist. And at the very end, she mentions that there were people who told her that she's a social media makeup artist, and so therefore she wasn't a real makeup artist. And even though I'm a regular artist, not a makeup artist, I still thought I wanted to chime in with my thoughts because, you know, because people like me still get people telling us ridiculous things like, well, you're a YouTube artist or you're an Instagram artist or whatever, so you're not a real artist. Here's another video I made about things people say make you not a real artist. If you want to see me doing the rest of this painting, I did that in the last video that I uploaded, which was about working on clear primed linen. This has nothing to do with this video, but earlier this month, I celebrated my 30th birthday, and my mom wanted to get me something really special for it, and inspired by the new logo that I designed for my business, which is, well, it's actually right below this video. It's a little round blue circle with a butterfly in it, which was actually taken from one of my paintings. This is the painting I'm talking about. And she had this woman named Cecilia, who is a jeweler who lives in our neighborhood. She designed and had this pendant made, which you can see is strung on a necklace. It's strung on a chain so I can wear it as a necklace. And I'm going to get up close so you can see it. It's white gold. I just wanted to show that to you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I make art videos. So if that sounds good to you, click here to subscribe. And actually, if you click this link right here, it'll take you to my most recent video before this one. But for now, thanks for watching and goodbye.